I bring up my job a lot, but I don't think I've actually specifically told you what I do for a living. This guy right here drives a truck with an eagle on it that was actually copyright sued by the... Oh, I ran out of gravel. No more gravel? Gotta go get the gravel. Copyright sued by the Seattle Seahawks because the image on the truck was too close to the Seattle Seahawks' thing. And it's a job that I don't really advertise that I have because everybody thinks of my job as a lazy man's job, and it's so much harder than people think, but nobody really wants to know about that. And when I got the job, I thought it was going to be just like Mr. McFeely from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. And it's not like Mr. McFeely. I'm going to put my dirt in there. Because now I got a shit ton. Okay. I should bring the path all the way down here. I want to get rid of that and actually make a place for that. I deliver mail in South Florida. And the truck's without air conditioning. And the problem with me is I'm one of those fill-in people that if there's a route open, I get to do it. So I'm not doing the same route every day most of the time. And usually in the summer, I work 3 to 4 days a week. But a person at my job is just real sad. From the same area as me and or my relatives in Canada, Nova Scotia. She, very awesome person, but just contracted a high-level stage cancer of the lungs because she smokes. And I want to just check something. Okay. For a second, I thought I might not have hit the record button. I was thinking I was not recording any of this video, so obviously I'm going to check the audio too. But everything's working as it should be. She just got lung cancer, very aggressive form of it. And seeing that I'm the second to top guy that doesn't have a real route, we bid on her route and I got it. So instead of working 3-4 days a week, I'm going to be working. I'm going to have to get a whole bunch of leaves now. And a couple. I want to make that look better. Does that look okay? I don't know. It's decent enough. I guess it's a path. Pink. I'm definitely going to have to build that bridge. And it's cockeyed a little bit. Going to have to come over here a bit more. Do I have any? Oh, and I got stairs to put down too. I can expand it with the stairs. So I am responsible for her route till she comes back or the other option. And unfortunately, her cancer is so strong that it's probably going to be the other option. And so I am going to do her route until the other option happens. 6 days a week. And I should take that one. I want to bring this over. I wanna be adored. So yeah, so I'll be working every single day of the week, except for Sunday, even though we do have people who work on Sunday. Amazon gave us a whole shit ton of money to deliver packages. On Sundays and holidays, so the lower people get to do that. I had to help once at Christmas time, but I don't mind doing that. Hey, you just hit me with you got me with that too. Really? Actually, that first one that she threw at me scared the hell out of me. I'm like, what the fuck just happened? The witch kind of got me thrown off subject. She got me good. Thank you. I'm kind of like a fill-in. I'm waiting for enough people go regular that enough people retire that I can go regular is basically what I'm saying. And I was 37 at one point, not the age. And now I'm number two in line. And now I'll be working every single day in the summertime, which kind of throws what I was planning on doing here on YouTube a little bit. But it's a good problem to have. So, where's my. So I'm happy about that. Let's just take those. And it's unfortunate for Sherry, but I had to go through the same realization that smoking's bad for you, and if I wanted to live, I might want to quit. And that's a realization that was, believe it or not, a very tough one to come to when you're a smoker. And she's in chemo and she's still smoking. Yeah, I mean, people who haven't had to really, I didn't think I would be using that many. I just don't want to have to jump if I don't need to. Because I like being able to walk like that. That was pretty cool. So yeah, I remember so the reason why I'm telling you about the work thing. Total loss of thought there for a second. There's a reason behind the story. And that reasoning is I just started a whole bunch of new series, as you probably have seen. And I may not be able to keep up with it now that I'm gonna that I know I'm working as much as I going to be. But it's summertime, not as many people are down here, even though it's one of the bigger routes in the post office. It's not that big a deal. So it's probably going to take me an extra hour a day, and my 2 to 3 days off a week that I thought I was going to have is just going to be Sunday. But with the scheduling that I have kind of come up with, I think that is fine. So we'll see. Let's see. Do we have any food? I hate that. Okay, I think what I'm gonna do is extend this pathway out to right here. Where's my gravel? Gravel? Is that all I have left? I did... That is probably all I have left. Yeah, to you too. Let's go to the island. And figure out what's going on here. I kind of wanted a little bit of an easier episode today, just because the last one I did was super frustrating in the fact that all I did was run around and dig holes in the Nether. You know? Digging holes in the Nether all day long is not fun. Where's my boat? Where'd my boat go? I know I came over here with one. What are you doing running away from me? So I had like the episode where I was in the mines, and then I had the episode building in the darkness, then I had the episode building in the frickin' Nether. And so I'm like, I gotta have an episode where I'm fucking outside. Not literally fucking outside, but fucking outside. And what it, well, now let me ask you another question. I swear a lot in real life. Does that turn you off? Does mall swearing turn you off? Does it not turn you on, baby? Does it really bother you? Should I be a clean mouth motherfucker? Or should I... Or should I not swear? What do you think is better? And let me define better. I would prefer more views. And I think not swearing in videos will help with views. So I even when I watch people, other people, and they swear, it's kind of like, really? Why are you doing that? So I guess I answered my own question right there. Don't fucking swear, you fucking bitch. It's just a part of my life, I guess. There we go. I knew I had some more gravel. It just looks so much like the other stuff. I don't want to make too much of it because I need this other gravel to also work with the dirt. It looks like it's getting dark out. It seems like they have the shaders on again. So when you're in a dark area... I mean, let me show you. The clouds on the horizon there, kind of gray. But come in here where it's dark and they get like almost black. Gray wool color. And you come back out, plop, and they're white again. That used to be a thing, and it looks like it's a thing again. And I'm not a big fan of that thing. I don't like being in here and it looks like it's raining out. I can't tell what's going on outside. Just have it bright. Yeah, just have a bright, man. So, again, let me know. Swear or not swear? And speaking of swearing, I watch a lot of those road rage videos, like car crash compilation that would say like May 2015 or whatever. And a lot of it is Russian because... there's a lot of insurance scams in Russia. So what people have been doing is putting dashboard cams on the dashboard so they can get people trying to scam them out of money or whatever. And you can always hear the Russian swearing. Is this going to break? No. I like that. Why am I not getting out? There we go. So, I have a Russian friend that's a famous YouTuber, Olga K. And I sent her a message. So, what does this... It sounds like sugar, but it's like suka. She's like, that means bitch. I've been talking with her for a couple years. I've been trying to get her to teach me all the Russian swears. Go look her up. Olga K. She does vlogs and stupid stuff. She's kind of... I don't know. Don't tell Stacy. I have a thing for Russian women. Yeah, so if you're Russian, watch out. Oh, wait. If you're Russian and you're a lady, watch out. Shh, don't tell Stacy. Okay, for this section, I'm going to have to do this because friendly creatures, I'm not going to listen to you. Much better, thank you. So, there's that. Oh, they're doing the blow drying outside. Yes. Let's blow the leaves around because in an hour and a half there's going to be a big thunderstorm with 60 mile per hour winds to blow a new set of leaves off the ground. I hate that. I've actually seen them blowing the dirt and stuff around during storms. It's just like, really? But that's what they get paid for. Hey, I fell in a hole. So, now that you know that I'm a postman, I'll tell you something I used to do. And I wasn't going to do this at the post office, but I used to work at the IRS also. And it was funny, because when I worked at the IRS, one of the first things they told me, say you're at the supermarket, and you're trying to get some groceries, and you're going to ride a track, and they ask you where you work, you don't tell them the IRS, because you will be assaulted. It happens all the time. Tell them you work for the Treasury Department. And it was funny, because I was part of the management over at the IRS. I got out. After 9/11, so this was a long time ago, after 9/11, we started getting so many anthrax scares and stuff, and I'm like, my life ain't worth this stupid company. So I left. I mean, it was like 16 or 17 straight days we had to evacuate the building because of anthrax scares, and it's just like, you know, I have so much better things to do in my life, like play guitar, play Doom. Yes, I could go home and throw in my floppy disk for Doom and play it on my DOS running computer. Windows, what's that? So yeah, I don't work for the IRS. I work for the Treasury Department. And I kind of feel that postal people are hated just as much as IRS employees. We are respected, unlike IRS employees, but we get a ton of shit also, because believe me, you misdeliver a letter once to somebody, they'll remember that for the rest of their lives. Oh my god, a Mexican could have stole my identity if they took mail out of my neighbor's mailbox. What is wrong with you? I'm like, that happened 3 years ago. And what people don't realize with the post office is the volume of mail that we get. I ask, you know, people ask me what the size of your route is, how many people I handle, and most routes that we do are between 800 and 1800, depending on the size of the route. Which means if the average person gets 4 or 5 pieces of mail, that's 2,000 to 5,000 pieces of mail a day. And every single misdelivery we hear about. Well, I shouldn't say every single one. That's a little exaggeration. But if somebody has a problem, so let's just say at 99% accuracy, and I have 5,000 pieces of mail. That means I'm delivering 50 pieces of mail wrong each day. And the route I'm doing this summer is one of those huge ass mother effing routes. I'll curb my fucking swearing. And I try and tell people that, you know, with the amount of mail volume we have, it should be like once, at least once a month, at 99% delivery accuracy, you'd have a misdelivered piece of mail. So get over it. We're human beings. We haven't been replaced by robots yet. Mistakes happen. I don't care if it's your check from you swilling your boat or if it's the ad campaign that you think was misdelivered because it says or current resident and you just see the fact that the people who owned the house before its name is on the bill and you give it back to me. You misdelivered this. They don't live here in 5 years. Well, I'm sorry. I don't have a history of your house either. So it's kind of stressful in the fact that you get the same exact questions all the time, same problems, and if something is misdelivered, they go, well, I got my neighbor's mail. Where's my mail? Sorry, you didn't have any mail? How do you know if you're misdelivering my neighbor's mail to me? It's tough because we're expected to be perfect, and as a human being, I'll tell you, we're not perfect. Great company to work for, though, if you don't mind working a lot. And a lot of people think that when we go to work, our day is basically wake up, drive into work. Here comes that blower if you hear him in the background. Wake up, drive into work. I need some more. Do I have? Yeah. And jump in a truck because all the mail has been pre-organized for us. And just drive around town all day long. 70% of my job is inside the post office getting the mail prepared to leave. And if there's open routes, you can't just go, oh, wow, I guess this part of town is just not going to get mail today. No, that's where I come in. I do my route, then I go fix everybody else's route. So when you call in sick at the post office, somebody else has to double up their work and do it for you. So there's a lot of bitchy, crazy motherfuckers at the post office who don't like you if you call in sick a lot. And I'm about to get out of that status. I have probably a year left. And the worst part about that year is that I was going to do this in Boston, and I went to the Boston Post Office, and they said, oh, thank you for the carrot. They did not tell me thank you for the carrot, by the way. They told me it was going to be a 4 or 5 year wait before I could become regular, have my own route. I'm like, great, that's just way too much fucking time. I need things to happen immediately. So I can make tons of money. Aw, one of them grew... Aw, you meanie. You're not supposed to grow there, you jerk. So the funny thing is, my parents moved down here, to Southwest Florida, near Fort Myers and Naples. And they invited me to move down here, not with them, but down here kind of close to them so I can kind of take care of them if they get sick or whatever. And I said, yeah, I'm not moving down there unless there's a career job. And my mom's like, oh, well, hold on a second. And she asked Joanne, one of my coworkers, hey, is anybody hiring? Do you know of any places that are hiring? She's like, oh, yeah, the post office is hiring. And, you know, I said, oh, I'll try the post office. That sounds like an easy enough job. Just jump in a truck and deliver mail all day. I didn't realize there was more to it than that. As most people don't realize that. And you may put my thoughts and words that I'm saying right now under, oh, another disgruntled postal employee. There's a reason why there's disgruntled. I totally understand. You did it too! What? Or is this the same guy? It's the same guy. Okay. I totally understand why there's disgruntled postal employees. It's not saying that, let's just say, don't say shoot inside the post office. It's just one of those jobs I think is under-recognized. The value of it is not under-recognized. But if there's a mistake made, it's not forgotten for a long time. And you'll hear something like, oh, this carrier always misdelivers my mail. When in all actuality, it was misdelivered once 4.5 years ago. But we don't get the forgiveness because I think, and I've asked people, how many houses do you think I actually deliver mail to? And, they'll say, oh, you probably have 50, 60 customers. And it's like, no, I have 1,275. No. Take 5,000 letters and put them in 1,275 different piles. And you'll kind of understand what I'm getting at. Then we have to deal with the parcels, and parcels have increased a lot. Thankfully, because of Amazon, they gave the post office a whole bunch of money to take care of their orders. And because the post office is obviously losing money because of everybody's doing email and stuff, and only old people really use the mail. Even I pay all my bills online. It's not like I'm going to throw 50 cents on a stamp so I can fund the post office. I just do whatever's best for me, which is not using the post office. Yeah, so don't use the post office because I'm a postal employee. So obviously the first class letters are going down. Unfortunately, they're filling it with a lot of junk mail. And I almost feel like some days that I'm spamming people's email addresses, but instead of it being an email address, it's a house address. I mean, they'll get 7-8 letters, and one of them is something that they want, and the rest of them aren't. And I hear Spider, where are you? Okay, I thought I heard you running towards me. Maybe you're underneath me. But I've some of these real rich people in town here, they'll get 4 to 5 inches thick of mail. You know, they'll get 6 or 7 magazines, 25, 30 letters, and they'll go pick up their mail. They'll look through it right in front of me because some of these people live in high-rise buildings. And they'll take one letter out and throw the rest of it away. And it's just like, you know, had I known you just wanted that one letter, I could have saved so much time today. But people aren't, most of the mail is junk mail nowadays, and I kind of feel bad spamming people with junk mail because I hate it in the real world, like with emails and stuff, and I hate giving people junk. But there are enough people that do enjoy the stuff. And that's another thing. You could do a thing a certain way, but that certain way, no matter what, is not going to fly with some people. And I'm just, I could use the post office as an example. Like, what I used to do is like, well, if I have a package, I will deliver the package to the door, which is what we're supposed to do. Walk up the driveway, deliver it to the door. So you ring the doorbell to let them know that you're there and walk away. But then I realized people like it much better if you ring the doorbell, kind of hang out for a little bit, and, oh, here, by the way, here is today's mail. You bring their mail up to the door, which is actually illegal. Because officially, mail is supposed to be only handed to customers through a mailbox unless they show you a photo ID and prove to you that they are who they are. And we have these stupid meetings every once in a while that says, don't worry, that Bob Smith on your route that you've been delivering mail for 7 years could be a terrorist ready to take on the country, so you better not hand them mail, even though you've known him as Bob Smith for 5 years. He might be Abdullah Hamdan Hussein. So make sure he shows you his ID before you give him the mail, even though you've done it, you know, handed him the mail 10,000 times before. It's just like, why is everything in this country based on fear? It's not, I don't know. I'm starting to do a postal rant. I didn't mean to be doing a postal rant. But I do, the job is very hard. A lot harder than I thought it was going to be. A lot more stressful than I thought it was going to be. But I am glad I have it. But at the same time, I do not recommend anybody else to get it. To get a job there. Okay. Let me just see something real quick. Okay. I am gonna get some. Where's the sun? I'm gonna make a bridge. Why not? I don't know. Should I get rid of the grass in here? I think it kind of makes it look better. I should have just leveled out this thing right there. But I don't want to terraform too much. Uh-oh. Close your ears. No. 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 Stop it. Ah. Thank you. I didn't want it to pull out all my torches. I am going to... Do I have any birch wood? Smooth stone. Where's my wood chest? There's the two birches for that. No, I don't... Oh, here's some birch. Here's some of that. Do we want oak? No, but we'll take some of you. And I'm going to take you with me for a minute. Let's go make a bridge. Bridge making! Bridge making time! Bridge making time! It's time to make the bridge. So, yeah. That's right. Yeah. How about that weather, huh? Oh. I kind of went off on the post office thing, and I didn't really want to, because as is, postal employees are kind of known as a-holes, and I was just proving the point there. Yeah. With the post office also, it's, oh, I never did finish my story about, Jesus, I told you I was going to get the job in Boston for the post office, and, oh my God, there's a cave around. I wonder where that cave could be. I don't see one here. I was going to get the job up in Boston, and they said there was this long wait, and I'm like, that's too long. And then my parents invited me down to Florida, and I was able to get the job down here. Are you gonna die? Thank you. And, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's do 9. Because I wanted to take care of my parents a little bit down here. I'm like trying to look for words. I kind of My mind keeps going blank on me. Unblank my mind. Let's see, where we go.